Welcome, this is Mr. Travis 779 with New and Old, coming to you from something different today for this week's update. I am at the lake. Very nice. This is my favorite place to camp. Not my favorite spot, but favorite place to camp. This is our but I mean, it's not a bad spot. Not a bad spot at all. It's a nice little camping thing. Nice little area. I mean, it's a beautiful place. We'll walk down at the lake and maybe take some snapshots later on. But as you can see, look at this beauty. I mean, look at what you can get for, you know, a small fee. It's like $35 a night to camp here. It's not $29 to $35 a night for full hookups. For partial hookups, it's like $25. For non-hookup, it's like $15. So you get the life of luxury, and you get basically a nice area. So yeah, I mean, we've got the heat. We've got the heat on, and we're just relaxing, taking it easy. I'm gonna close this tank because we don't need it open at the moment. We got all the hookups in. We leveled the RV. Truck did fine. No problems. I didn't film anything because it's already have done that in the past, and we all know how it tows. Just look at my I'll link a video from the first time I took it out camping, and I'll show you guys how it towed. In that video, you'll see how it towed. Used only one tank of gas coming up here, so about 100 miles, but yeah, works good. I do like it. I do think it's a good area. Got the nice trees over the RV. I'm not too crazy about that, but that's okay. Okay, got a little tunnel. Yeah, a little dog tunnel or something in the tree. That's kind of cool. That's really cool. So yeah, this is Mr. Travis 779. Later today we'll take a walk at the lake and just kind of show the beauty of this area. Anyways, I'll see you in a few. Welcome, this is Mr. Travis 779 of the next day, and I had a good night's sleep. A little wet, but everything's going good. I did find out one thing with the RV, and the tanks do not work. We have a little issue with the sending units on the tanks. I found that out the other day. I found that out last night. The gray tank I know is bad. I don't know about the black tank yet. We haven't filled that one up, but I assume it's probably bad too, as it hasn't registered yet. So yeah, it's another problem that I'm gonna have to deal with in the world of a lemon RV. They were supposed to fix them. But they never did. So what can you do? But yeah, this is just a nice little chilly out here. I would say it's in the 40s. high 30s, low 40s. We got the heat on the RV, warming it up, and yeah, it's a little chilly. It's what you get for camping in May here in the Pacific Northwest. But anyways, just wanted to give you a heads up and a nice little documentary video on this beautiful camping trip. I mean, I still enjoy this, you know. Yeah, it's chilly, and yeah, it's pouring down rain, but, you know, it's still nice. Still nice. And anyways, this is Mr. Travis 779 with New and Old. We're going to cook ourselves some breakfast here and just relax for the day. Nothing really special. We don't do much. We didn't bring the boat to go fishing or anything. We really couldn't afford fishing licenses. And to be honest, bringing the boat is a little bit of a pain. We have to... Yeah, it's just a pain. I don't much care to bring the boat. I mean, I have to do something different making that boat. I have to do something a little bit different on that boat. But next truck, whatever the next rig is, we'll rig something up. As you can see, it's just a beautiful. This park is a beautiful park. This is a Kansas State Park. It's a state-owned park. But yeah, it's a beautiful park. They really worked hard to preserve the nature of the park. You really feel like you're in nature. You really feel like you're in your camp, and even though you've got full hookups. So, very popular park and very nice park. Anyways, this is Mr. Travis 779 with New and Old. Y'all have a good one.